It's a special election day for students at Lincoln High School.
So this is Pierce County Elections. We're glad to have you here. You guys have your election. You guys brought in your ballots in here. We're going to process these in a little bit. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to give you a tour of our facility.
The reason they're here today is because of a partnership between Pierce County Elections, the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department, and Tacoma Public Schools.
Kids have actually been given the opportunity to decide, to directly decide how to spend $60,000 at their school. So we are finding out the results to their vote today.
We check every single signature of every single ballot as they come back in. And this machine helps us do that. It actually takes a picture.
Learning how a ballot is processed is all part of these students carrying out their own election.
These are our scanners here, and you guys are actually going to help scan your ballot.
My students at Lincoln had the opportunity through a health department grant to vote on various proposals for a project to improve our health at Lincoln High School. And we have the opportunity to come open our ballots and put them through the ballot counting machines, which is, for me as a government teacher, is awesome. It's like democracy in action.
Now you guys are going to actually be opening your own ballots.
After a quick lesson on how to securely open and sort ballots, it's time for students to roll up their own sleeves. It's a new strategy in community engagement called participatory budgeting.
This process is essentially an exercise of, you know, one of our basic rights as American citizens, and that's to vote.
Lincoln High students submitted 550 ideas on how to spend $60,000 to solve one problem. The top seven ideas made the ballot.
Some of the options included replacing our water fountains with water bottle filling stations, to renovate our bathrooms, because our bathrooms at Lincoln for students need a little bit of a facelift. So we also had on there an option to have a activity bus.
It's definitely needed. The boys' bathroom doesn't really have a mirror in it.
Like, we're in a really low-income school, so most of us we can't picture $60,000. Like, I still can't picture what $60,000 looks like and is going to do for us.
Voting's important, and this will help the kids, you know that this is an important and real thing, and there's real consequences for voting, because their money is going to get spent by how they vote. So there's meaning to it. Now, putting a face up in the bottom tray.
So everything was real. Real money, real process, real time, the entire life cycle of public policy.
So why was Lincoln High School chosen?
Lincoln High School is really large. It has 1,500 plus students. It's the only school serving the east side of Tacoma, which is a really large neighborhood with multiple zip codes that cover about 20,000 plus people.
The health department says they found a connection between areas of low voter turnout and unhealthy communities.
Poverty, poor health, and low voter turnout are all very highly correlated, and it's hard to say which is causing the other.
Community leaders want to see if civic engagement changes those unhealthy trends.
I'm doing a voter registration campaign at Lincoln High School. Our goal is 300 students to get registered. And so I think coming here and learning this process is very integral to what we've been learning in APGov.
But getting kids involved early and getting involved often might make them better voters in the future and get them more engaged overall in their whole community.
I would definitely take my vote more seriously now in the future.
In the end, more than 1,000 students cast a ballot, and the $60,000 winner took 32% of the vote.
And the winner is bathroom improvements.
I feel like a lot of people underestimate how much of a direct impact you can have when you're voting, and I feel like this kind of like reaffirms the fact that like you're directly like doing something that can influence something so huge.
I have a feeling that the youth that participated in this exercise, I think, are going to be regular and discerning voters, and we need them in our community.
Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.